Are you ready to see something cute? Loads of people spend hours online watching adorable videos like these. They even reward themselves after a hard day with a quick shot of cute straight from the internet. But why do we love taking in animal babies so much? What's going on in our brains when we see something we think is adorable? Well, baby, it's all about survival. I'm Erica Bergman, and we're wired that way.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
When you think cute, what's the first thing that comes to mind? Probably one of the puppies or kittens or other animals we just saw. They were downright darling. But why do we want to cuddle them? Well, it turns out they have a few features in common. Big forward-facing eyes, round ears, flappy limbs that cause unstable but heartwarming movements, a soft rounded body shape, and a very large head compared to the rest of their body size. These common features make up what's known as kinder schema, a set of traits that humans identify as adorable. Know who else has these features? Yep, human babies, who are also quite squeezable. The fact that baby animals have these traits in common with our own species is actually the crux of why we see these critters as cute. Appearing lovable has a lot to do with a baby's survival. When your brain recognizes the features of a human baby, two things happen inside your noggin. First, your orbital frontal cortex, which is responsible for decision-making, springs into action. It tells you to protect and nurture the baby in front of you. Second, the nucleus accumbens, or pleasure center, is activated. It releases dopamine, the same chemical that's released when we fall in love, have sex, or take certain drugs. So it's not too far off when someone says, "These videos are addictive." Both of these features activate at the same time to tell you to protect the baby and reward you for doing so. My brain did this very thing when I was at a dairy farm in Maui. A little baby goat came up to me and started chewing on my shorts. Normally, that's not a thing I'd encourage. But look how cute and adorable his face is. Who can say no to you, tiny mister? I just want to cuddle you and take care of you. The good news for human survival is most of us react this way to any baby, not just the ones related to us. That greatly increases every infant's chance of survival because everyone is looking out. The fact that our brains are wired that way helps our species survive and explains why we see animals other than humans as cute. Our brains are looking for babies to protect. In fact, our love of kinder schema gives our brain a hit of dopamine when we see cartoon characters that look like babies or objects that look like babies. Kinder schema also helps explain why most of us don't find creatures like reptiles and insects and fish as engaging as other mammals, even when they're babies. Animals like this tegu don't have features that make us all gaga. I mean, you're cool, dude, but we are so not cuddling later. The science of cute doesn't stop there. We see adult dogs, cats, pandas, and more as cuddly long after they're babies. That's because they retain their kinder schema as they mature. Take this adult hamster. Big eyes, big round ears, and a large head, and these goofy, unstable movements. Yep, this guy checks every box, especially the one in my heart. When an animal holds on to its kinder schema as it ages, this is called neoteny. Lots of mammals exhibit neoteny, and humans are no exception. Our children keep many of their pleasing baby features for over a decade so that adults help them survive into puberty when they become gross teenagers. I mean, just look at me. What do you find cute? Share your thoughts, ideas, and fuzzy animal pictures and videos in the comments below. So there you have it. Being cute is all about survival. The next time you find yourself binge-watching internet videos of puppies, remember, it's okay to indulge in adorable. We're wired that way.